Hey, brother, there's an endless road to rediscover. Hey, sister, know the water is sweet, but blood is thicker. Oh, if the sky comes falling down for you, there's nothing in this world I wouldn't do.
All right.
Yeah, so what's this in the background? A copying machine, paper, plastic for lamination, hemp rope. Some kind of device for making holes with. A laminator. I don't know. Anyway, this is the last part of the miniseries about gathering, processing and storing wild edible herbs. And I do it on my old device to keep the same quality, or rather non-quality, as the previous two videos in the miniseries. Anyway, these are the stinging nettles that I showed you how to pick and how to dry, and they are super dry. Very. And I'm going to show you a little processing and a little storing. So, I just simply take the t-shirt, fold it. Nice. And then I go into another room. Of course, there is only one room. Here. It's sort of a mess in here, so we'll see how it goes. It's very dark, isn't it? It actually didn't help at all. We'll see here. What kind of situation we can create. Yeah, this will have to do. Whatever. So. If you want to try if they are dry. This is actually not super optimal. Yeah, a little better. If you want to try if they are dry. You can either take a mortar and take some of the herbs. Into the mortar. Like so. And then grind them up. And if they turn into a powder, you can start with your fingers, of course, to pre-grind them a little, so to speak. And then you go on with the pestle. Yeah, and if they quickly turn into a very dry powder, as is the case, do you see the case? Yeah, you get it. Then they are dry. But you can also take the herbs as they are, so to speak. So let's say, yeah. Put them in a glass jar with some sort of tight lid. And then put on the lid and put them in some cupboard or whatever the case may be for a day and see if there is some kind of condense. If there is some kind of condense, they are not dry. Anyway, these are very dry. As could be seen here with the little mortar thing. Yeah, so for storage I recommend this sort of thing or Uh, maybe a thing such as this one. Even though it's a plastic lid, it's not super unoptimal. Or a container in stainless steel or paper bags. No pure plastic. That's the case. And they will automatically store until the next season. And it's very optimal if you have used them up until then. So, I'm going to show you a quick little version of the processing here. That I consider to be supposedly optimal. Grind them into a very fine powder with a mini mortar or any type of mortar. Takes like no time with wild edible herbs, especially stinging nettles, since they are inbound. And then you take one of these. Stainless steel sieve. And a pot. And then you just strain it through to get rid of the bullshit. Yes? Powder in the bottom, bullshit in the sieve. Get rid of it. And then you take a distilled water. Distilled water, an amount of your choice. And if you want to be really hardcorely technical, you can take a meat thermometer. Yeah, you know. And yeah, you take an amount of distilled water, I'm just going to fetch it. Hey, morning! There's an endless road to redefining. And you put the distilled water into the pan. And then you can just pour it a little back and forth between the glass. This is not super much, but it's just for the experiment. You pour it back and forth like 10 times or what have you. An amount of times. Until it's totally mixed. It's the case. And then you put it on your stove. As is actually visible in the background. And you don't have to heat it on the lowest heat. It might be nice if you do so, but I'm going to take it on like 3 of 6 here. And then you can preset this thermometer. 42 degrees, it's like the maximum cap for raw food. And then you just put this one in, and when it's finished it will beep. Yeah, that's basically it. I'm just going to put the rest of the stinging nettles here in the glass jar. And when it comes to these things, don't overdo it. However, there are tons of wild edible greens out there that can be picked. But as always, I recommend that you follow the rules. Nice places, nice plants, don't destroy, don't deplete. When it comes to foraging. Of course, in the long run, when people return to sanity, so to speak, we are going to have to do some kind of natural farming. It's easy as fuck, but it might going to have to be the case, unless people spread out again. Stop being so city-nized. And so on. We have to do some kind of natural farming, and it's super easy. Of course I will do a video on it to give you my thoughts on it automatically. Yeah, but this is it. Now I think that there are no doubts about the whole situation when it comes to gathering, processing and storing wild edible herbs. If you watch this mini-series in three parts, you will basically know everything that is worth knowing when it comes to this topic. Of course, I didn't show a tutorial of all wild edible greens that are available out there, but there are many videos on this channel and there are many videos on other channels, and there are books and there are pages online if you live in Sweden. Skogsskafferiet.se is the shit. It's a very good page. I learned a whole lot of shit about wild edible plants from that page, but there are also other sources, of course. Check out many sources when it comes to identification and inspiration regarding wild edible plants. Let's see. 32 degrees coming up. Yeah, this is just an example, as I have said a couple of times, but here we have it. A jar full of perfectly dry, perfectly foraged stinging nettles in perfect condition. And here you store them, away from sunlight, not too hot, not too cold, and so on. And when it comes to the amounts, it's totally up to you, but don't overdo it. But of course, in a very short amount of time, you can pick a year's supply, or the supply that will last you until it's time to forage next year again. If you pick a whole lot of different herbs, that is. I always recommend variation, variation, variation. Do not eat and drink the same herbs every day. Or over time.
Grader! Det är nästan 42! Britta, vad ska vi göra? Vad ska vi göra när vi sitter och väntar på att vattnet ska bli kroppstempererat så att det är optimalt att dricka? Så att inte kroppen slösar en massa energi? Oh, sorry about the Swedish. Or actually, I'm not sorry.
Ett gammalt glas. 39, coming up. It's like a 15-minute cap on YouTube videos when I upload it from this kind of device. Otherwise I will have to split it into several parts. And it's 40 degrees right now, so I think this will be a very optimal situation. I have about a minute on me to, yeah, do the usual roundup deal, so to speak. 41 degrees. Yeah, and of course you can pour it a little back and forth here. Sharp. Maybe a couple of times to mix it even further. And if you want to be really hardcore, you can put it in again to see too that it's somewhere in the range of, I don't know, Around 40 degrees. Okay, it's around 40 and it's 10 seconds left! And yo, thank you for watching. Have a nice now. Ciao!